it's the first year that we've done some serious winter training. At least twice, if not three times a week, the ladies have been out. It's been quite hard, so it's quite nice to see that come to fruition. Crew today is led by Claire B. She's in stroke. Stroke sets the rate for the boat. Zoe in five, absolute strength of the boat, brilliant timing. She's strong, quite smutty. She'll love me for that. I'm Natasha. I'm the ladies' captain and also the coach for the club. So I'm in four.
We're all following her, effectively. Natasha will tell us off if we're...
If we're not keeping, like, often me, actually.
Time.
And if I'm not keeping in time or get a bit enthusiastic, then she's the one that calms us down, keeps our heads, and she's our leader, basically. We follow her and respect her. So she's up there.
Three, we've got Carol. She is a powerhouse. So competitive, but also a great character with it. Number two is Sarah T, calm, cool cookie. Number one, we've got Emily. She's our live wire. She's unbelievably competitive.
But we're competitive. We want to beat everyone,
and
be the best.
The ultimate team around North Devon is Ilfracombe, but that's probably...
It's in our sights.
This is Appledore Gig Club's regatta. We do one once a year. It's a big one. It's all the local clubs. So there's Torrid, Ilfracombe, Barnstable, Bideford, Clovelly. So gig racing is quite a strong history. It was based originally on pilot boats going out to meet big ships, merchant ships coming in, families racing against others, and so that whoever got to the boat first, the ships, they'd be able to put their pilot on, and they would be the only ones that got paid. It very much was winner take all. It was, you know, their livelihoods depended on it.
There's two clubs that I've got to worry about on the day, and that's Ilfracombe and Torridge.
Len, obviously, is the coach and the cox, and he is a very gentle, calm, quiet man, mainly through the training, but when we get into a race, it's quite a different story.
Okay, after this race, the 10 hours. That's 1, 2, 3, next one. 1, 2.
The start gets you your position. It's an explosive thing. The main aim, other than winning the race, is to get to the first buoy first. If you can get there and control it, suddenly you're away.
8, 9.
Emily did the first time she's done the tossing of the oar, and it was absolutely phenomenal. And I could see them, we got really close, we tied in there.
So, keep it there.
Literally halfway around, you're in hell. They're in amazing hell, but everything is blowing just maximum power. It is so hard. And you can see Ilfracombe out of the corner of eye, and you know you're getting closer, and you know you're getting closer.
Sit tall! Just drive.
You know in that boat that every single person in your boat is going to try their best. So if you don't give 110%, then you're letting your best friends down.
Even though it's a small little village, even though that it's totally inconsequential in the great scheme of things, at that one moment it means everything, everything to everyone in that boat. It's a phenomenal result, it really is. To come second for us and be so close to Ilfracombe, it's not just coming second, it's being that close to Ilfracombe. We'll have them by the end of the season.
I could tell, I could hear their breathing.
And you're only like a boat length off them.
Yeah, maximum. Yeah. Amazing.
We have to be honest, Ilfracombe did beat us a little bit on fitness, but we will be there next regatta.
We've never been that close.
5, 6, 7.